All right, so we're making some good progress. We've covered the first three steps. The last step here is updating our student DB util. So this is where we're actually going to make use of the add student method, and we're actually going to put the real JDBC code in there for doing an insert into the database. So just a quick recap here in our student controller servlet. In our add student method here, we have a call to studentdbutil.addStudent. So that's in place right now. But what we need to do is actually put some real code inside of that method. So I can just go to this method here and navigate to it. I'll show you this little Eclipse trick here. I can choose the method, right click, and I can say open declaration. Or I can hit F3 and it'll actually take me directly to that code. So that's an Eclipse trick for you. So now I'm in my student database util right now, and I'm at this method here, add student. So dbutil add student. In this method, this is where we're going to do our JDBC work. So we're going to get low level, get a connection, all of that good stuff. So let me clear out this method here. And again, I always like to start with comments just to kind of let me know what I need to write. So I already know up front I'm going to need that throws exception. So I'll just go ahead and put that in there now. So I'll need to create a SQL statement for doing the insert. I'll also need to set up the parameter values for the query. The parameter values for the SQL based on the student's information. I'll need to execute the SQL insert. And then finally, I'll need to clean up my JDBC objects. So that's basically the game plan of things that I need to do in this method for adding a student. So I'll just set up some basic JDBC objects here for a connection and a prepared statement. And I'll also set up my little try catch block here. And also take care of the imports. So import java.sql.preparedStatement. All right, so let's start off here with creating the SQL for the insert. So this is the SQL that we're going to do for actually doing the insert into the database for the student. But actually, I actually need to get my connection first. I forgot about that. So that's the first thing we're going to do here is get our connection. Now we can go through and write our SQL string. So I'm going to make use of SQL. I'll say insert into student. That's our table name. Then I need to give the actual columns and then the actual values. So the columns are first name, comma, last name, comma, email, and make sure you keep an extra space at the end of those lines there inside the quotes. And then for values, I'll make use of the question mark placeholders because I'm using prepared statements. So prepared statements are based off of placeholders, and you fill in those placeholders or param values with actual data. So I'll go ahead and set those param values now in this next piece of code. So first off, I'll just kind of prepare the statement up front, say my statement equals my con.prepare statement based on that SQL. And now I can go through and set the actual param values. So here I can say set string. I give the parameter index of 1, and I give the value of the student.firstname. So the parameter values for prepared statements are 1 based, meaning that the first one is at 1, not 0. So don't want to confuse you there. All right, because everything else in Java is 0 based, right? Like arrays, but param values here for prepared statements are 1 based. So anyway, 1 for first name, 2 for last name, 3 for email. All right, so that looks good. So we have all the param values set. Now it's just a matter of executing that SQL statement. So I simply say my statement.execute, and it'll do the work. So it should take a student, perform an insert into that student table, and there we go. So that's kind of the big game plan there for this method in our student DB util. So get a connection, create SQL, set the param values, and execute the SQL insert. And then finally, I need to clean up the JDBC objects because I have a connection object and a statement. So I simply use a close on mycon, comma, my statement, comma, null. This last null here is for a result set. In this case, we don't have a result set, so we simply pass in the value of null. And that's it. So we have our add student method in place. So we are ready to go. Alrighty, so let's do that. So I'm going to go ahead and run the application again. It's going to give me my list. I'll hit the add student button. I'll enter the data again for Andrew Whitaker. And andy@lovetocode.com. Then I'll hit save. And then, boom! Check it out at the bottom. Andrew Whitaker. So he's actually in the database. And this is really, really cool. I'm excited about it. But you may wonder, I don't believe you. So let's go and actually look at the database. So I'm logging into my database here. And I will go to this web student tracker, my table student, and I will query that table. And then there it is. So he's there at the bottom. So he's ID number 6, Andrew Whitaker. So, you know, the data really is making it into the database. And so we have our database interaction. So this is cool. So we did the full circle here of, you know, writing the code all the way from the beginning and then following it all the way to the back end with the database util. So I would say mission accomplished for the add student feature. So I'd say good job. We made it through it.